Joining me now from London is Luay al-Khatteeb. He's the founder and executive director of the Iraq Energy Institute, an energy think tank and consultancy. He's also an advisor to the Iraqi parliament. You know, I want to get first to this issue of the dam. I mean, we've heard the two scenarios. You know, the fear is that ISIS could either let the dam break, which means it's going to flood large parts of the country, even reaching as far as Baghdad, or that they would sabotage it or cut it off, which means it would cut off the country from an important source of water. Do you see this as a larger problem, ISIS actually targeting the main infrastructure of the country and continuing to do so?
Well, Paula, this is a significant milestone that's been achieved over the past 24 hours. But this is not, doesn't mean a victory. There are many steps need to be taken to really declare victory. The ISIS will definitely regroup. They have an ample supply of recruits from Syria, over 25,000 foreigners ready to cross the border at any moment and outnumber any troops. And their agenda, they are just coming to die. The situation in Iraq, it really requires a significant cooperation with all forces, national forces on the ground, notably the Iraqi army, special forces, as well as the Kurdish Peshmerga. And we've seen that the result of the cooperation together with the support of the U.S. Airstrikes have achieved something good. And this has saved Iraq from a significant catastrophe that could have caused a humanitarian disaster in the downstream provinces.
Right. And if we turn then now to the oil infrastructure that's on the ground there, you know, oil prices actually have been quite low. They do not reflect the turmoil. Do you believe then that Iraq is able to safeguard most of its oil infrastructure and that it can be kept out of the hands of ISIS?
Well, most of the oil infrastructure are predominantly situated in the south of the country. But ISIS tactics is very much creating as much havoc and disturbances inside the country to play the media, the international media. We've seen the international media reacted positively towards the Mosul dam takeover by the Peshmerga and the Iraqi army. We saw the Brent oil prices dropped, so as the West Texas intermediates. But having said that, in terms of the infrastructure, yes, they could be affected, but not in terms of like producing field. The producing field are very much in the south. They are very safe, and they produce at least 90% of Iraq oil from Basra. So in the short to midterm, I see no threats to that, but the operation need to be sustained to prevent the return of ISIS to the dam. We saw the track record of ISIS in terms of like opening the gates of the Fallujah dam and creating some havocs in the central part of Iraq. And we don't, but the Mosul dam is at a larger scale, and this is something that Iraqis and the international forces really need to work together to avoid any further catastrophes.
Yeah, and we hear your point. ISIS will come back. They will not go down without a further fight on the front lines there of the Mosul Dam. Thanks so much for your insights this morning.
Thank you for having me.